Greetings, fellow citizens. Marlokus has published his 3.6.0 live data, and there are a few differences between this and his previously published 3.6.0 PTU data. Well, this is to be expected. In this video, I will look into changes to missile and torpedo damage between 3.5 and 3.6, and we will take a look at the new ballista missiles. And here are the changes to missile and torpedo damage between 3.5 and 3.6. Obviously, we don't have ballista missiles here. Those were not in 3.5. You can see the different tiers. Tier 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 9. And the different tiers were buffed differently. Size 1 missiles were buffed a lot on average by a factor of 8.82. Size 2 missiles were buffed on average by a factor of 3.48. Size 3 missiles were not buffed that much, only by an average factor of 2.56. And size 4 missiles were buffed even much less, on average by a factor of 1.99. Size 5 torpedoes were buffed by an average factor of 2.22, and size 9 torpedoes were buffed by an average factor of 5.7. Now, I understand CHE wanted to make size 1 missiles useful, but I don't think it makes sense to buff size 1 missiles that much and buff size 5 torpedoes and size 4 missiles only a tiny little bit in comparison. Now, it was important that size 9 torpedoes do a good amount of damage, but this I don't understand. And here you can see the different sizes in one picture. Top right corner is a size 1 missile, bottom left is a size 4 missile. Now look at the difference in size. Now you could argue, yeah, the size 4 missile is bigger because she can fly much longer distances, but even the warhead should be very much different. However, when we are looking at the data, one size 1 missile does about 50 to 60% of the damage of one size 4 missile. This doesn't really make sense, Chris. Now, I don't think those numbers are final. No, they are not final. They will get changed again. And I don't want CHE to change the sizes of missiles, torpedoes, each and every patch to make it more believable. But I really think we have another big problem. And this problem is, why do we have so many different missiles and torpedoes? Let's be honest here, this game isn't exactly easy to develop, and this isn't exactly a game where you can very, very quickly find your way into. So why not just have one short-range missile, one medium-range missile and one long-range missile? And have different detection systems, for instance radar or infrared, and you can just change those, switch those if you like to. At the moment you want to fire the missile torpedo, and have one short range torpedo, one medium range torpedo, one long range torpedo, and if you really need to have one big size, I don't know, 15 torpedo for our big capital ships. This would make this much, much easier, and yeah, I don't think you need that many different tiers. And here we have all the missiles, including the new ballista missiles. Those are marked red. What's interesting here, you have the missile size, you have the tracking type, you have the tracking distance, you have the lock time, damage total, damage physical, damage energy, and explosion radius and velocity. And interestingly, cross-section missiles torpedoes have a longer lock-on time than, for instance, infrared. Cross-section 1.31 seconds, infrared 0.59 seconds, same for torpedoes. Cross-section torpedo 12.22 and infrared torpedo 7.04. Maybe if you want to have a faster lock-on time, use different torpedoes or missiles. There are some interesting changes between 3.5 and 3.6. Before, I think 3.3 missiles did almost always only physical damage. Then came a change and missiles did still mostly physical damage, but a little bit of energy damage, and we had some, I think, two missiles that did biological damage. And now in 3.5, missiles and torpedoes do a lot more energy damage and only about 20% physical damage. And no biological damage anymore. And the explosion radius is interesting as well, because it doesn't make sense. It says, for instance, Raptor has an explosion radius of 2. And if you look at those numbers, there's a rule kinda, the bigger the missile torpedo is, the larger the explosion radius, but size 4 missiles don't follow this rule. But this number is wrong. I know from my tests that Raptors have a much bigger explosion radius than size 3 missiles, so this number is for sure wrong. Next interesting things, yeah, let's look at the new missiles of the Ballista, Scimitar. Scimitar does less damage than in Stalker 5, that's interesting. And Helion is a size 7 missile and is in between size 5 torpedoes missiles and size 9 torpedoes, which makes sense. So now we are looking at the maths. Yeah, maths. Well, I read on Reddit that one size 5 missile of the Ballista would kill a Cutlass. And now looking at those numbers, I don't believe in this. We still have the problem that we cannot decide what missile torpedo to fire next. This worked perfectly well before 3.0, but even 6 patches later we don't have it in the game. So maybe people were shooting size 7 missiles instead of the size 5 missile. So maybe something was terribly bugged, but when we are looking at the maths, you can clearly see that one Scimitar should not be a kill for a Cutlass. And here's the maths, stay with me, this is very interesting. Since 3.0, calculated and observed damage is only a perfect match for the first missile and torpedo hit. Before 3.0 it was always a perfect match, even for 2, 3, 4 or more missile and torpedo hits. So we are calculating how much damage does one size 5 Stalker, this is the default size 5 torpedo of the Gladiator, to one Cutlass. And this size 5 Stalker does more damage than one size 5 missile of the Ballista. It does 8865 damage, this is so much physical and so much energy damage, and I don't want to read all the numbers. Now, we don't have real armor in the game yet, but all ships have some generic armor value. And almost all ships have a damage modifier against energy of 0.9. This means you have to modify this number. Multiply it by 0.9 and you get this number. And this is our new modified damage one size 5 Stalker does to one Cutlass. Now, if you are aiming at the front or at the rear, one size 5 Stalker can hit only 3 shield faces of the Cutlass. And this is the best case scenario for the missile or torpedo, and this is bad for the target, because in this case the 4th shield face of the Cutlass is doing nothing for soaking up the damage and just chilling. So this much damage has to deal with this many shield HPs. Let's calculate. 10,938 minus 8,156 is 2,782. 2,782 divided by 10,938 is 0.25. This would mean we should see on our display shields 25% front side stern max. This is calculated. Let's see what we can observe. Shields 25% front side stern max. I tested the Cutlass, I think, a few days ago. Well, it's a perfect match. I'm always very happy when this happens. And this means that one size 5 missile of the Ballista cannot destroy a Cutlass, even if you are only hitting 3 shield faces. So either the cutlass was already damaged or it was an NPC cutlass. Next question, can one size 7 missile of the ballista destroy a cutlass? Well, I cannot test this in Arena Commander because I cannot spawn my ballista in Arena Commander and I am not in the mood to test this in the universe right now. I will make some ballista videos later, but not at this time. One size 7 ballista missile Helion does so much damage, and this is so much physical and so much energy damage. And again, we have to modify the energy part, multiply by 0.9, and you get this new modified damage one size 7 Helion does to one cutlass. Now, looking at the explosion radius of one size 7 Helion, I don't think you can hit only 3 shield faces, but we do both calculations for hitting 3 shield faces and for hitting 4 shield faces. If we would assume that you can hit only 3 shield faces, which is very unlikely, then after we are doing all the calculations, 5809 damage is not absorbed by the shields and is hitting the hull, and this is very likely a kill for a cutlass. If we assume that a missile hits 4 shield faces, which is much more likely, then 2163 damage is not absorbed by the shields and is hitting the hull, and this could just be enough to destroy a cutlass. But I'm not sure, and this is something I might test in the future. And this ends my video where I look at changes to missiles and torpedoes between 3.5 and 3.6, and where I look at the new ballista missiles and where I show you how to calculate missile and torpedo damage. This works for every ship. And yeah, it's almost always a perfect match for the first missile and torpedo hit. I hope you found this interesting, I hope you learned something, and I hope you had fun watching this rather dry video. See you next time. Bye. Auf Wiedersehen.